We're going to look today at some basic terminology with statistics, and mainly what we're going to be talking about is comparing and contrasting a population and a sample. So a population is a set of all units that we're interested in studying. For example, we might be looking at all University of Arkansas Fort Smith students. A sample is a subset of the population that's actually measured. For example, we might only measure the students in one particular class. That would be a sample. A population characteristic is something that we measure for the entire population. For example, we might measure the heights of each and every University of Arkansas Fort Smith student. If we do the same thing for the sample, that is going to be a sample characteristic. So the characteristic is what we're measuring. So the population is the actual students. The population characteristic is their heights. If we do, in fact, record the heights of every UAFS student, we are measuring everybody in the population. That's called the census. So census is a measurement of every single population characteristic for every single member of the population. So a census is almost never done. You may have heard the word census as it relates to the United States government is supposed to do a census of the American population every 10 years. And at least in theory, they do that. But in practice, it's hard for them to actually physically measure every single or count every single person. But they do. They make an attempt to do that. But what we do more often, since we can't measure everybody, that's either impossible or costly or time prohibitive. What we do instead is we take a sample, hopefully a representative sample, and measure it. So this would be sample data. It's a measurement of the sample characteristics of every member of the sample. For example, we record the heights of the students in a particular class. Now, a parameter then is a numerical description of some property of the population characteristic. So for example, we might, after having measured the heights of all UAFS students, we could then average them, that is, add them up, divide by how many they have, find what we call the mean, or arithmetic mean, or average height. And that is what's called, that would be the population mean, which is a parameter. Okay? If we did the same thing for a sample, that's called a statistic. Now notice that we're using the word statistics in general to represent the entire body of techniques that we're doing here, the entire course, but we also use the word statistic in this sense as a numerical description of some property of a sample. So for example, if we find the mean height, the average height of students in a particular class, that would be a sample mean and that would be a statistic. Notice we got some nice alliteration going on here, which help you keep these straight. Population, parameter, both start with P. Sample and statistics both start with S. Now in mathematics, we use both upper and lowercase letters to represent different things. So they're variables, but they mean different things. So you may or may not be used to this, but an uppercase X and a lowercase X are two completely different things in mathematics. For example, we use an uppercase N to represent the size of a population. So uppercase N is then a parameter. Whereas we use lowercase n for the size of a sample, which is thus makes lowercase n a statistic. So uppercase N and lowercase n are two different things. Now our normal letters come from the Roman alphabet, but we also use letters from the Greek alphabet as well in mathematics, particularly in statistics. Typically, we often use population parameters. We use Greek letters for them. So, for example, a Greek lowercase sigma right here, see it? That is a lowercase Greek letter sigma. That stands for a population standard deviation, something we'll talk about a little bit later on. The corresponding measure for a sample, we use the Roman letter S, lowercase s here, or in other words, our regular S, for the sample standard deviation. In fact, A uppercase sigma, lowercase sigma, uppercase S, and lowercase S are four different versions of an S. They're four different versions of a S sound, right? But they're four different things in mathematics. Okay, it's time for you to do a couple of questions here. If we measure the entire population, we are performing a blank, fill in the blank. The proportion of the portion of the population we actually measure is called a blank. Classify the following as either a parameter or a statistic where the population is all UAFS students. A, the average weight of all UFS students. B, the average height of the students in this class. And C, the number of automobiles driven to campus on a particular day. Press pause, answer these, and come back when you're finished. Okay, let's see how you did on these. If we measure the entire population, we're performing a census. The portion of the population that we actually measure is called a sample. If the population is all UAFS students, the average weight of all UAFS students is a parameter because we're basing it on measuring the entire population, right? Everyone. The average height of students in a class is a statistic because we're only measuring a sample and basing it on that. Number of automobiles driven to campus on a particular day is a statistic because the population there would include all automobiles all days. So a particular day is a sample. Finally, I want to talk about one more topic in this video, and that is sampling. Basically, what we want to do is it's very cost prohibitive, time prohibitive, to do a census, to actually measure everything. So what we almost always do is measure a sample. But then what we want to do is take that sample and infer something about the entire population. But for that inference to be accurate, that sample must be representative of the population. For example, if we were measuring, want to know the average height of UAFS students, we could go take a group of students, do a sample, and measure their height and use that to estimate the entire height or average height of all students at the university. Now, the problem with that is if you're not careful about the way you do your sampling, you can get erroneous results. For example, if I decided to take as my sample the men's basketball team, then I would probably get an average height of the men's basketball team that's just much higher than the average height of all students at the university. So you have to make sure that your sampling methods are very good. And we may talk more about sampling methods later, but I do want to mention a little bit about it right here. So two ways that are generally considered pretty good ways to go at sampling are what are called a random sample and something even stronger, which is called a simple random sample. And there's a pretty subtle difference here between the two. A random sample is a sample in which every individual member of the population has an equal chance at being selected as part of the sample. That's the definition of it. A simple random sample is a sample in which every subset of members of the population has an equal chance at being selected as part of the sample. So a simple random sample is a random sample, but it's a little bit stronger or better. So here's an example of a way we could do a random sample that's not a simple random sample. Suppose we wanted to take the population to be all statistics students this semester at our university. So place a section number for each statistics class in a hat, choose one section, and then measure the heights of all students in that class, and use that to infer something about all statistics students. Okay, that's one way to do it. Notice that every single individual member of the population has an equal chance of being selected as part of the sample. So that is a random sample. But it's not a simple random sample. For example, if Betty is in section 1 and Frank is in section 2, there's no way that both Betty and Frank will be selected. Maybe neither one, but not both. Whereas a simple random sample way of doing that would be to take the names of all the students in a statistics class this semester, mix them up in a hat, and randomly choose 30 of them and measure their heights. Now notice that not only is every individual member of the population have an equal chance of being selected, but also any any subset of 30 has an equal chance of being selected. So in order for us to use data to draw meaningful observations, conclusions, decisions using the data from a sample, the sample must be representative of the population and the underlying assumptions needed for our methods must be met. If the data collection is flawed in any way, then the conclusions derived from that data are meaningless. So here's a little phrase that I learned back when I was doing programming, and it definitely applies here. Garbage in equals garbage out. If you have a flawed data collection or a flawed method of using that, then you're going to have flawed conclusions. Your conclusions are meaningless. So that's it's very important that we use a representative sampling of some kind. Usually a random sample or a simple random sample is what we would like to use. So hopefully in this video you learned some basic terminology. We've cautioned you a little bit about sampling, and this gives us some basic terminology that we can use to move forward with the rest of the course.